for the Earthlings, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. We are in front of the fighter's guild right now in Wayrest, although I wanted to be in Quagria, but yeah, it's fine. Go to the game up here. It's been a while since I played this game. Hello there, random human. I was essentially taking a short hiatus and resting up. I did a lot of traveling and was super tired. So anyway, now that we're here, let's go ahead and grab the next rank of the fighter's guild. Before that, I would like to address the fact that I have actually been... Well, how do I put this? Yeah, I'm trying out a new piece of hardware, audio recording hardware, so let's see how that goes. I'm hoping it'll make the audio quality better. If not, I'll just revert to the older hardware. If it does, then I guess I'll just stick with this current hardware. Anyway, let's get a quest from this guy. Probably should have saved before, but alright. Listen, Grimfangs, if you hadn't already done a bunch of jobs for us already, I wouldn't even suggest this. But this is a job I don't even want to tell you about. It sounds like crying for the moon and more dangerous. Okay. It's offing a lich in Bedyrick Laboratory and it only pays 588 gold. You're not interested, are you? Of course I am. I knew I shouldn't have mentioned it. Listen, if you're really gonna do this, get the best stuff you can get. Magic stuff, ebony blades, what have you. Actually, I'm glad that this guy's actually giving me some advice on how to clear this quest. This lich has to cross Oblivion in 17 days, and you gotta be back here within that time to get your reward. You're unbelievable, Grimfangs. Good luck, you're gonna need it. While I am pretty sure that I would need the luck, I'm also quite certain that... how do I put this? The lich isn't going to be as dangerous an affair for me. So, they were, from what I saw with my previous lich encounter, they were pretty powerful in Arena. Not as much in Daggerfall. Bedyrick Laboratory. Let us go ahead and travel to Bedyrick Laboratory. At least I found some nice quest. I think this, we do go to like another laboratory during our, I mean, we should have had the option of going to another laboratory during one of our other quests, basically. I forgot which quest it was, but I'm wondering whether I should just wear these tights. Yeah, cast when you silence, and when these are cast, they will use fireball. So I think silence is a far more important spell, but you know what? Let's go in the piece. I'll take them off now. I think I can use them even with advice. And venom antidote. It doesn't hurt to use them, so. I think these are good luck. Yes. Paralysis. And I think. Oh, feet of Notorgo. I think that increases your movement speed. That gives you like a speed buff, and I think, yeah, these are the boots of free action. So anyway, let's go ahead and raid this dungeon. Let's see how many quests we need to complete for the fighter skill to get promoted to the next rank. I'm just gonna save it in the dungeon entrance right here, the way I usually do. Two parts here, and I don't really need an ebony blade because I already have a Daedric blade in my hand. That's the first time I've heard the soundtrack, and I must admit that I actually like the soundtrack. Unless it's because of a glitch that the soundtrack is sounding like this. But I do like the soundtrack. Now I wonder where that goes. Okay, so that's pretty much the only way we have to go. Laboratory, huh? Are you coming up? Oh, yes, there it is. That seems like a long ride. So here's what I'm gonna do before I get on this elevator. I'm just gonna go ahead and save you, because that seems like a pretty long ride. A very long ride. And I've got no idea what's at the bottom of this mess. This place seems gigantic. There should be some enemies here. I wonder why there are no enemies here. Of course, I'm going to be taking all the gold and maybe the ashes. Thank you very much. I can already see some enemies up there. Now, what I do have with me is like this. It's essentially an ebony bow or an adamantium bow, yes. So I can use this to damage, you know, undamageable enemies that I considered previously undamageable. Yeah, these seem to be human warriors, so I don't know if I wanna. Yeah, that's just a sorcerer. Ranged is still a better form of attack against these, you know, miscreants. Yeah, I guess I better save some arrows for later. I've got 9 arrows left, and I better save them. Wait, where did... Oh yeah, it's... I sort of got concerned there that I don't exactly have a shield, but yeah, Auri-el shield is a magical item. I was supposed to look in the other tab. I was wondering how there are like literally no people here, but I guess there are. They just didn't render in. Which is strange, because typically in places like these, they do tend to render in quite quickly. Time for you to die. That's a backstab! Wait, did that guy have a tail? Or was it just like a part of his uniform? I wonder. Okay, now since that encounter was successful. I don't particularly like that kind of stairs. Those kinds of stairs, I mean. I just want to quickly check if there was like a hidden door there, somewhere down there. Does not seem to be the case, because, I mean, this was not the module for hidden doors, but... Huh. I wonder why there's like a walkway plank here, like a gangway plank of sorts. But yeah, this module shares similarities with others of its kind. Hey, what are these? These seem nice. Elven greaves. Pretty sure they would fetch me a pretty penny, but do I really have enough space to carry them? Might as well, right? And I wonder what this is. Huh. Just like something hanging there. For no good reason. This should lead me upstairs, this path. And that path should lead me in a different way. Of course not. This piece is far more convoluted than that. Daedroth died. Which is good. Which is a good thing. Daedroth should die. They should not remain alive. These guys do hit hard though. They still do hit hard. I want to check out this side first. Let me drop something here just to mark the way. Mark the fact that I've already been there. Log is not interfere from me since I am increasing my battle mage died. Yeah, since I am increasing my spellcasting abilities, might as well just go ahead and use it. Yeah, might as well. Nothing here except for this skull. Does this do anything? Probably should save before I try touching it. Otherwise it can cause all sorts of problems. Again, a locked door, which got open pretty easily actually. What I find quite confusing about this game is how the sorcerers are essentially melee classes in this game. They behave more like warriors than actual sorcerers. But I suppose that's just how things are at times. So this area is a dead end, nothing here. Good thing that we ticked it off the map, checked it off first. I'll try going there next. Actually, I'll rest here. Just because I like to be on top of my healing. Moving on, we can either go down or we can go into this tunnel here, which of course takes us higher up. That's a Daedroth. The Daedroth died, which is good. The Daedroths are good Daedroths. This is Frost, might as well. I don't think I've encountered an enemy that uses frost damage in this game yet. Except for perhaps the Ice Daedra, the Frost Daedra, whatever they are. Is that a vampire ancient of some sort? No, just a battle mage. I feel trained. She trained me. If only that happened in real life. If you catch my drift. Okay, this. Yeah, we're going places right now. We are going places. Let's stay on the same level for now. We'll come back and check out other places later. Like, playing this game is sort of like a memory challenge. Okay, a giant scorpion. That does not know I'm there. These guys still take like 2 hits to die, which is strange. I hear a wraith or a ghost of some sort. Steel staff. One thing that I'm glad about in this game is that this game actually has things like... I'll go there later. Let's keep this door closed for now. Oh, okay, that's a zombie. One of the tougher enemies in this game. Who opened this door? I did not. Maybe it's because I swung into it on accident. By accident? Yeah, by accident. So there's a zombie in here. Yeah, nothing here. Good thing that we marked this off. Let me save here. And we'll now continue on our way. Okay, battle mage died, spell was reflected, and that is amazing. I mean, Auri-el shield is really shining through there. Like, it automatically reflects spells for you, which is amazing. Like, absolutely amazing. I would like to kill you first. Thank you. So, this is a sorcerer. They don't use any spells. I mean, at least I haven't seen them using any spells thus far. Which is something that I find really strange. So, fully armored, suited up sorcerers that don't use spells. Seems quite strange to me, actually. Backstabbing, jumping, archery, critical strike. All improved. One fell swoop. I was wondering if I'm saying something wrong there, but no. That's just how it is. Okay, we'll come back here later. For now, let's just keep the store closed. Let's mark to marky. This path has haven't been visited. Oh! No, wait, it's not. I thought it was a room with the globe, but I mean, it is the same room, but I haven't had. It doesn't have the globe here. There's supposed to be a globe there. I mean, I can't really say that there's supposed to be a globe there, but the similar room that I visited in the past, which is I think in the Roost of Skulrathrac, does have a globe right here, and it just adds so much character to the game that it's amazing. Find like a globe there. Let's go here. I did not drop anything here because there was a door. The zombie died, which is good. Ooh, I'm getting lots of data loot. I wonder if it has anything to do with my character's level. I suppose it does. This should be an empty place, like a place with nothing. So is this. Good. Good thing we got that on the map. The fact that these areas were indeed empty. Interesting. So with that being done, let's just go ahead and save here. Just as a measure of progression. Measure of progression. Huh, even this module is similar. Just that it has more clothes hanging on the walls, which I had not seen before. I wonder if they're supposed to be lab coats, like scientist lab coats. Look at all the Daedric gear that I'm getting. My god. It's insane. Like, I can like literally replace my entire inventory with all the Daedric gear that I'm getting. Let's put something down here. This module is similar to the Roost of Skulrathrac. This module is not. let's go down here first. In the Roost of Skulrathrac, this was like a locked area. I don't know why it's so locked, but I suppose it was meant to be like the king's treasury of some sort, because this entire area is full of both guards and essentially, well, gold. So that's that. Torture devices. Well, at least we have some loot here. I'm picking up the flowers because they don't take much weight. This should be lootable, but I mean, if you go into a shop, that thing is lootable, but not in dungeons. You can't loot out of them in dungeons. It's just only in shops. Yeah, let's go this way. Let's check out this side first. Okay, this is a locked door. The spell was reflected, which is amazing. Otherwise, it would have been bad news for me. I can't carry any more stuff, which is... Well, it's fair, because I do have lots of Daedric stuff on me. So I can't exactly blame them for making that decision. I hear an underwater area. Hi there. That's a sorcerer. I mean, these guys can't fight for shit. I'm literally spamming the same attack over and over from the same angle, and they still manage to get defeated. Says something. Says a lot of things about the level of skill. Let's just stay here then. And we'll go up there later. First, let me clear out this side. Or should I just go upstairs first? You know what? Let's go upstairs first. Of course I can't. I just dropped it, but I can't carry it anymore. Oh, fuck you. I did not mean to sound so aggressive, but yeah, that is an underwater area now. Could be that the Lich is beyond it, but I'm not eager to check it out right now. Not right now, no. I suppose we just go here first. Alright, let's get back out of here. Somebody opened this door. I see. Auri-el shield is amazing. It literally reflects half the spells that are like literally chucked at it. And I personally find that amazing. I mean, yeah. So I've got three sabers right now. I've also got this, you know, elven greaves. Now I could probably go back and put them into the wagon, the beginning of the game. But I'll do that the next opportunity that I, the next time that I get near the entrance. Let's go here first. I hear a zombie. Huh. Well done. Should I hit the lever first? Just to see what happens. Maybe. No. Wait, have I been here before? It would seem so, yes. We have been here before. Okay, there are two levers here, and I wonder why there are two levers here. And what the purpose of these things are. I've already explored that away. Oh! Okay. So what does this lever do? Does it actually, like, bring it back up or something? I guess not. I don't know what that lever does. We'll come back here first. I wanna explore this side. I have like this procedure wherein I leave. Ah, of course. No wonder. This will open up this gate. In a lot of ways, this level is similar to the Roost of Skulrathrac. Of course, that did nothing. So I suppose it's this lever then. No. Okay. Is it perhaps that lever then? Or perhaps a combination of both the levers? I mean, that's the only possible solution that I can think of. Huh. Unless what it's really asking me to do is essentially go down there and release another switch, flip another switch, so to speak. Because that lever on its own does not open anything. So see, this section is a lot like the Roost of Skulrathrac. Let's go left first. I mean, this is yet another yep, this place, this module is just like the Roost of Skulrathrac. There's even like something up there. Wait, there's a guy there. Yeah, there you are. Sorcerer. Supreme. So the Roost of Skulrathrac has its door right here. This is where the like dungeon entrance is. No, I can't exactly carry anything. Ooh, what is this? Of course we don't know what that is. Let's carry some of this blood. Of course can't carry any more wound. Right then. Should I just hit one of these switches here? Just to see what's gonna happen. So, the other lever is just hidden there. I'll get back to it. Hi there. Of course I can't carry any more stuff. Let me just save the game here. Now this dungeon already has me confused. Yeah, so this is where it should be leading me. And that is where we came out from. Okay, let's go back upstairs then. Since we have already been there. I do not recall whether we have completely searched the place or not, but we have been there completely. So let me do something else here. Let me try going up first. and then we'll see what else can be done. Silent Tides. Yep, I can use Rapid Fireballs even if I'm not fearing it, which is good. Venom Antidote, Paralysis, Boots of Paralysis. Ooh, I've got two Paralysis enchanted items. This is Frost. I'm looking for Levitation. I do hope I have Levitation. I do, at least one. Whoa, I'm fleet-footed right now. I wonder why that is. Practically floating all over the place. Yep, two cards here, as expected. Sorcerers at that. Now, do you have anything for me? Orcish Bleed, not really good. I mean, considering what I already have, it's not really all that good. Although, I could probably, like, remove this thing into her inventory and take the Orcish Blade from her. Of course I can't. Why did I even bother? Yeah, thank you. That's something. Can I, like, thank you? I can't? Okay, fine. Must be nothing then. Now this thing will open and close this trapdoor here, so I'm not gonna touch that. But what I do want to do is... yeah. This is probably going to ruin things a little for me. I do hope that I don't fall into a ditch down here. Like, the levitation spell does not give out before I can make it to the appropriate level. But if I recall correctly, all it does is just, yeah, reverse the polarity of this thing. I'm also going to stick to the wall just in case so that I can start, yeah, climbing as soon as the levitation spell gives out. You see, one of the things that this chain here does is it enables slow falling. Now, while I personally don't like slow falling, because you have no control over your character while you're falling. Yeah, look at this. I have zero control over my character as I'm falling. And you can even, like, at times glitch into through the walls like this. So, that's sort of sad, but at least you can fall. I mean, the fall won't hurt you. That's one thing. And sort of need to wait here until this thing, more or less the slow falling wears off. No, I'm actually gonna mute for a while because there's like this idiot outside that's a hawker that's shouting at the top of his voice. So until that guy goes away, I'm just gonna silence my end for a bit. Yeah, that guy's gone. So, I don't know how good the noise cancelling abilities of these new headphones that I have are. I have used these before and they used to be pretty amazing, but I don't know how good they are at this point in time. So, that's something that I'm gonna have to just wait and see, essentially. Now, this thing isn't moving and I wonder how I can open this gate. I could not find any other mechanisms, to be honest. So I guess I'll just have to search throughout the, you know, the entirety of this dungeon and see what we can come up with. Where did I come here from? I came here from there, okay, fine. I mean, she finally noticed me. Battle mage, a durable battle mage at that. Impressive. She put her points into constitution. I guess I'm silenced right now because this is. Oh no. What is this potion? Recipe for potion of stamina. Let me go and put this again. Where is it? Yeah, right here. Nothing here. Lock is not in fear from me. Can I rest here? Of course I can't. Hold up. Let me try doing that over here. Enemies nearby. What about over here? Yes, I can. I can rest here. I wonder if I've cleared that area out first. Like before this, I mean. It would seem that I have. Right then. We head back out and we continue this way. I can hear something. Something quite strange, but yeah, we've already cleared this section out. Let me just go and save. I still do want to try that wheel at the top of that platform there. There's another one of these things here. Should we just... yeah, might as well, right? Let's try it. Let's see where this takes us. I don't know why my camera went all wonky like that, but yeah, it happened. So I've never been here before. Let's try going this way. Maybe we'll get back to the critical path through here. Ah, this is the guy that I could hear. A zombie. They still do get hurt. I mean, the story behind zombies being so difficult is basically a glitch in the game. Okay, both of these paths take us down. One path more directly, the other path more roundabout. But hey, it's pretty much the experience of dungeon crawling in Daggerfall. You never know what you're in for. You never know what you're in for. Unlike prison. But they tell you what you're in for and how long you've got to stay there. In Daggerfall, it's just suffering. And you I have no idea how long it's gonna last. Or why you're there. I mean, you're there of your own volition, actually. Because you wanted a taste for adventure. This guy tried to silence me, huh? Funny how that worked out. Spell was reflected, amazing. I mean, Auri-el's shield is doing wonders for me. I love it, I love it. A short sword, not bad. Okay, so here's the thing. Oh yeah, like I was saying about zombies. They weren't really supposed to be as difficult as they are. They're supposed to be far easier to deal with, but what happened is there was like a memory allocation error and long blade itself has improved. I wonder what my long blade is like right now. 85%? I wonder why it's white though, like that. Maybe because it just got upgraded? Could be. But at any rate, I need to get this up to 89 or 87, I believe. So, 4 more percentages, or is it like 2 more percentages? I don't recall it more at this point. But yeah, I need to get it up. And no, I do not want to load a game, I want to save a game into a specific save slot. Right then. So, we have already been here. We went that way. Right. So, you know what, let's go back up. Let's see if there are any areas left unexplored. Then we'll come back down here. So, as you can see, I mean, when you keep just blindly exploring the dungeons, and especially marking the places that you've been like this, you more or less eventually get to exploring the entirety of the dungeon pretty smoothly. So, yeah. Which way did it come from? Which way were we going? I think we were supposed to head that way, right? No, the other way. Yes. North. There is nothing here. How wonderful. So we head back, I suppose. I have not found any other levers in this section, is the problem. I just want to check this thing out once more, see if there is any mechanism by which I can open this gate. I feel like the lich is behind this door. Could be behind this door. I also want to try twisting the flywheel in that room, but. Yeah, I don't know what that's gonna do, to be honest. It doesn't really do much. It's pretty much just there for show almost. Seventy gold, and I think I heard a scorpion? No, a Daedroth. It was a Daedroth, not a scorpion. And you've got a shield. Too bad I've got Auri-el shield. The Auri-el shield is amazing. It's practically a tower shield, even though it does not look like one. And it reflects spells. Not only it can even give you like resistance to fire, resistance against fire spells, which is amazing if you ask me. It's iron seems darker than the others. Whoa! What is that? Holy shit! First time I've seen that decoration in a dungeon. As in that module, in that dungeon module, some poor soul was tortured here. Yikes. Any hidden doors thus far? None that I can see. Let's see here. Have you been down here yet? Seems that is where we came up from. Okay. So that means that the only place remaining for us to go is back here. Now I really do want to quickly try turning back the flywheels there and seeing what happens. I mean, one of the flywheels I'm sure will only make matters worse for us, but the other one I do believe could be helpful for us. I just want to quickly check. That's all I want to do. I think it was like this way. Nah, it was the other way. Excuse me? Thank you. Oh, right. I accidentally locked myself in here. Well, no worries. It's quite simple. Quite simple to fix, to be honest. Yeah, we essentially need to climb up there and let's see here. We need to be facing, well, east. Right. So let's start climbing. Sorry, west, not east. I always confuse the two. I don't know why. Probably because I keep thinking like west is left, left is west, right is east, or something like that. But yeah, I keep confusing the two. Should I just use a potion of levitation? You know what? Let's go ahead and rest here. Until I'm fully healed. I'm not gonna waste like a potion of healing for this section here. But what I am gonna do is save in the emergency slot and go ahead and see if I even have a potion of levitation. I just wish I had something that gave me like a levitation. What do I call it? Enchantment. Pure poison, water walking, one more levitation potion. I hope it is not the last one that we have. Can you like levitate up, sir? Oh wait. My mouse was still active. I was wondering why the mouse is still is not active. I couldn't see it on the screen. So yeah, sort of a bit confused there. So yeah, we were supposed to head east. Oh right. I never bothered to switch it back, apparently. Which is my bad. Which is totally my bad. Should have done that to begin with. Now, quickly, we must be quick here, otherwise it's gonna be difficult for us. This locks this thing, right? Yeah, so this is not what we're looking for. We're looking to first unlock this. It's good that I eliminated the possibility of, like, essentially that being the case. Yeah, we were supposed to go west, not east. We were supposed to go west. It was my bad. Yeah, I'll just stay here. And now what? Well, I can try both flywheels. I think I'd already spun this before. I'm not certain whether I had or not. But at any rate, it's gonna lock up one of these doors for us. Since the other one did nothing, I'm not really too hesitant about Like hitting the switch for that one, I mean. Thank you. I don't know how you managed to get glitched into the platform there. But I'm hoping that the flywheel more or less just unlock this place. If it did not, then I have... Oh, it did. It was basically the flywheel that I had to use. Grim, man. That's grim. I can see how they're horrifying things. Considered to be horrifying things. Just a Daedroth and a zombie, nothing else. No liches here. No liches here whatsoever. I like how none of them could even get like a shot off on me. The Daedroth only had like a steel staff. No wonder it couldn't do anything to me. And this house, of course, has nothing of value. Yeah. There's a little house inside the dungeon. I mean, there's somebody living inside this dungeon and even raising livestock amidst all these animals. Sorry, all these monsters. Oh, there's another flywheel here. I wonder if that... Yes, it does. Good to know. At least we, like, cleared this area out. So, yeah, that was indeed good. That was indeed good. I don't know what the other lever over there does though. Now, what I want to check out is whether there is something else that we need to do here. Something else that we might have neglected to do before. Seems to not be the case. Seems like we have explored this area in its entirety. Like this section in its entirety, not this entire area. This entire area is still lacking exploration. Quite a lot of places, so we'll just go ahead and keep exploring it. We go back down and we continue exploring that way, I suppose. Let's see. We'll go back down first. Okay, so which way were we supposed to go again? Right, this way. I think that's where we came from. Yes, it is. And have we completely explored this place? I think not. I think we are yet to explore this area. I think we went there, but it was like an underwater area, so we abandoned it. Yes. Should we go down here? I wonder. Let me save in the emergency slot in case it's a waste of time. Even though I do have lots of underwater potions. Water walking. Potion of water breathing. Right here. Water walking is like levitation but underwater. It lets you move really fast in the water, basically. I doubt this leads anywhere, but in case it does, the Auri-el. These guys like to call it the slaughterfish. I like to call it the Auri-el because that's what it is. Some more loot, but that's about it. Does not seem to be anything else here that I can use particularly, or even any tools that I can access for that matter. So I guess we'll just head back up. In fact, let's run back up. Well, now that we've cleared that, might as well save it. Like, save the progress on the map. Where else have we not gone? That area doesn't really lead to much. Pretty sure there were areas that we have not explored yet. Like this here area. So in order to get there, how do I get there? Question is, yeah. So we just keep following this path and we'll be led to an entrance here. Then we need to climb up. Actually, will we? No, we just need to take a left. And then we can just go ahead and explore this side. unless... No, it seems to be just blocked off. We have explored that area. Like, quests in Daggerfall can be so straightforward at times, and at other times, they'll leave you confused as to where you want to go. Now, what I am quite certain about is the fact that there are areas that we have left unexplored. And yeah, I'm just looking for where they are. It's not the case that I'm sure that I've completely explored this dungeon, because I know I have not. I have left a few areas that are yet unexplored, but like this here area, for example. So yeah, let's go ahead and explore that area. So how do we get there? Curious. How do we get there? I suppose there should be a link somewhere here? No? Has to be a way of getting there, right? So, there's a way here. And the way to get there is through the throne room. So basically we need to go back to the throne room. It's essentially what it is right now. Okay, let's head back to the throne room, and it's the same way to the throne room. Oh wait, there is some a part of this area that we have not explored, so let's go ahead and explore that then. Let's go ahead and explore that side, and then we'll proceed on to the throne room and go back upstairs to the other places that we have left unexplored. Alright then, so east is... I'm supposed to be turning right. Is it here? Yes, it is. And yeah, I'm supposed to be taking a left here. Could have probably just used the... We have been that way, we have not been this way yet. So let's drop some blood on the ground to mark the fact that we are going here. Of course, nothing here as expected. Otherwise, I mean, we would have been hearing monsters all around us. This is the way to the throne room, yes? No, actually, it's not. This here is the way to the throne room. Now, this gangway plank, I don't know why it's here, actually. You know what? I quickly just want to go down there and go back up, so that I can keep some of my stuff in the wagon and come back. Make some space for more loot, you know? Since we are at the throne room and everything. I mean, I don't understand why they have that thing there, because I jumped off it. I literally jumped off it and I suffered zero damage. So... it seems a little strange to me that they would do that. Yes, I want to stay and access my inventory. Sorry, my wagon. I've kept this because slow falling isn't really such a great thing to have. And what else can I keep? I suppose that is pretty much it, yes. I wonder if this is at all connected to anything. I mean, we have been all around this place, but we've been above it, we've been to the left of it, we've been to the right of it, but this place does not seem connected by anything, no. Like, connected to anything except for this one, you know. Thing right here. I could just climb up there, you know, instead of going all the way there. Let me just go ahead and save here. Alright, let's climb. Come on. look at her climb. I mean, she's like the master of climbing. Okay, so we want to go here. Because this route will just take us down there. There's nothing else to that route over there. So let's go upstairs. Let's go upstairs and see what else Pete has in store for us. Because if I recall correctly, this is one of the areas that I've not explored yet. And immediately I see somebody there, ready for a whooping. A sorcerer, from the looks of it. You can tell. £180 gold pieces, good to know that I can carry gold again. I hear another zombie. I don't know where the zombie is, but I hear it. Sorcerers, how come you guys are sorcerers but use no spells? Like, is it, are you guys like using enchanted gear or something? I don't know, what's going on with you guys? I'll just open this door up to demarcate the fact that I am going here. Okay, so I think this was another one of those areas where I had not previously come exploring. This pair of stairs as well. Like, this area upstairs as well. Not pair of stairs. I see a zombie and I hew it in the back. Attempted to essentially chop it in half, but the zombie was a little too durable for that. Nothing here, good to know. Stab. The double diagonal always gets them, doesn't it? I actually have like an interest in learning how to fence. Not that I do know how to fence, I've never had the opportunity to learn. Not the capital to do the same, but yeah, I do have an interest in learning how to fence, and I must admit that the names of these moves sound so cool. Like, Morto, and I don't know what the other names are, to be honest. I think there's a zombie behind this door. I saw something else. Yeah. Just a Sorcerer Supreme. More gold, 420 gold, hey, let's go. That seems like a Mithril sword. Mithril Claymore, yeah. They're nice, they just don't fetch as much gold as the weight they're worth. They don't really fetch their weight in gold, essentially. So I'm not particularly interested in them. Wait, I've been here, right? Yeah, I think it was a dead end. Yes, it is. So then, since we have explored this area as well, let's head back down and let's see. I think I have explored that area too. Haven't I? Yes, I have. We've explored. We've been down here this way as well. But seemingly, we have not explored these areas yet. So I guess that's where we go then. And what about this side here? I don't think we have explored this side either. Let's go ahead and explore that side first. Then we can go ahead and return to this area and explore more of it. I was sure that... Yeah, I thought we had come here, but I suppose... Wait, does that... I think I know what this area is and why it's showing up as unexplored, because... Yeah, there's like this coffin here, so we didn't really go towards the end. Okay, so there's like another area that we can explore over there. Let's finish this area off. I hear rats. Why do you even bother, rat? I mean, I can't exactly blame you, you're not the most intelligent of enemies either, but still. I mean, where's your sense of self-preservation, rat? I'll come back to you. I'll come back to this door here. Okay, let's go ahead and explore the store then. See what the store holds for us. Just to mark it off as a dead end. Now we've got two parts here. What the fuck? Where do you get off attacking me? Did not see that guy, he completely blindsided me. Oh, so this is where it leads down to? I think we have been here before. Oh no, we have not. Okay, this is a completely new area for us. Ooh, more... what do you call them? Daedric great weapons for us to carry. And sell, of course. Okay, this woman is deadly. Iron Greaves, now these are new, so I don't think I wanna exchange them. Although, if I could carry them, I would probably sell them for a pretty penny. Okay, there's like that entire door over there. I'll come back to you. I'm just gonna rest here until I'm fully healed because that woman did some damage. I'm fortified. Let me increase the music volume a little. I feel like it's a little too low. I previously kept it low because I could not... My spell was reflected, no wonder this guy bounced off. Yeah, previously kept it low because... what is this? Elven? So what's better, Dwarven or Elven? I think Dwarven. Right. But this looks so pretty, doesn't it? Maybe I could... Nah. Not worth the trouble of carrying it. So, we are at like a completely new area right here. We're yet to explore this side as well, so we just have to keep that in mind. And where do we go now? Let's check this side out first. I'm guessing there's a Daedroth behind me. No? That's interesting. 226 gold and anything else for of interest for us? Apparently not. 994 gold pieces, my god. These guys carry gold. Hello, I told you guys that. I mean, these guys carry gold. Well done. I think I hear a Daedroth, but I don't know where the damn thing is. Oh yeah, so I previously had kept my volume lower, my game volume lower, because most people could hear me speak when I was playing the game. Oh, that's a zombie. I was just thinking which way should I go. I was pondering it and this zombie shows up. Can't carry any more stuff. Let's go this way first. Let's see where this takes us. I haven't saved in a while. I think I have saved in a while, but yeah, let's just go ahead and save again anyway. Of course, this area has nothing. So let me go ahead and update the save here. Don't want us to be confused the next time we boot up the game and find ourselves in an unfamiliar spot. I think this goes up. Yes, it does. Let me just close the store back up again. Lich has to be somewhere around here. I don't know where, but it has to be somewhere around here. Daedroth died. Of course, I can't carry any more stuff. Now, I just want to quickly check this side out. I was saying the Lich is here, that's the Lich. And poor guy got his own spell blasted on his own face. Oh my god, that is hilarious. That is absolutely hilarious. So yeah, let's see what are the loot we might have here. But I suppose that is not the Lich that we were looking for, was it? Because we don't exactly get a message here saying that this was the Lich that we were looking for. I see a dead Lich, but not the Lich that we were looking for apparently. Yeah, I mean, I did slay a Lich, but I don't think this is the Lich that I was looking for. Yeah, I'm not going down there. You know what, might as well. We have the potions, might as well do it. I'm just gonna pause again. Sorry, not pause, just mute my side again. I personally would never have realized that there are areas like this down here if I had never, you know, venture into one of these places. But apparently these places can be pretty complicated. Although, I mean, there was that one area in between with the, what do you call it? The shallow area was sort of hopeful that, okay, maybe we have found the Lich that we are, like this area right here. I mean, this is a pretty well done area. I do not think that they could be in an area, underwater area especially like that. But turns out I was wrong. You never know what kind of areas there might be. Huh. So let me just save here, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna explore this area a little more. Especially since we have explored this part of the map in its entirety. Oh wait, we have not explored this place. I think that was the Lich, but I did not see any message pop up. Typically a message should pop up when you kill the objective of your quest, like eliminate the target of your quest. But that did not happen this time around. So there are two parts here that I can take. One goes down, one stays on the same level. Let me go down first this time around. Okay, so we have been here before. This is one of the areas that we neglected to check. We'll go back up and hold up. We still need to check out this side. Just for the sake of marking things off on the map. I do not think there will be anything much different about this chamber here. Oh, alright. So I know where we are now. Okay, so let's go back then. And this time we'll go upstairs. This is where we came from, yes. And I do believe we just did go down there and check whatever was there. I'll just drop something here in case we return. Come back this way, I mean. Yeah, now let me go back up. Like this way. Let me go this way and see whatever this place has to offer. This is an empty room, nothing here. more choices. This seems like an exact copy of the place that we had previously been to. And Dungeons and Daggerfall can be like this, and they can be very navigationally challenging when they are that way. And this is an exact copy of what we have already seen in one of the other rooms. In one of the other areas of the dungeon, rather. Can't carry any more stuff, of course I can't. So yeah, we've essentially been down both ways. And I do believe we even met a lich in one of these areas that we had previously visited on the way here. And yeah, I mean, we should probably head back now and go to the other place, go visit the other places that we have not been to yet. I think we came down from here, yes we did. And then where do we go? We have been here before, I do suppose we have. And now we have officially cleared out both sides of this mess. Oh, have we? Yes, we have. Yes, we have. Right then. So we go back here. At least I hope this is where I came from. I'm not terribly certain at this point anymore. I think that is where I came from. And what else? What else? What else? No, that is not where we're supposed to go. I think we're supposed to go there. That I do believe is the throne room. There were like a few other areas left that we had not explored previously. I just wanted to check out where those areas are, to be honest. We can go here. I wonder where the throne room is. Like, we've already been there, the throne room is not there. The throne room is elsewhere entirely. Is that the throne room? No, it's not. This place is expansive. This place is expansive, to say the least. So see, now I'm turned around, to be honest. I don't even know what this is, like these two dots on the map. Is it like supposed to somehow show me my distance to the objective or something? I think that is the way I'm supposed to take to get back to the throne room. I'm not certain though. Now I'm completely turned around. I'm completely turned around right now. Okay. That's the throne room. Okay. Let's make it back to the throne room first. Look, wait. Here's one of the other areas that we are yet to explore. So we basically need to get there. And where are we right now? That's a very good question. Where are we right now? I can't find myself on the map. Let me open the map again. Right, we're there. And we need to essentially get fair. Where's the throne room? I lost the throne room again. Figuring out where to go in this game is challenging, to say the least. That's us. That's the throne room. And that is the path that we are yet to explore. So, essentially what we do is... how we get there is we go down and we take a right and we end up in a dead end. So we do not take that right. No, we do not go down. We take this road here. And what do we do with that road? We take it down? No, we don't. How do we get there? Okay, so we use this here chamber to go here and then nothing. That does not lead to anything. Oh no, it does. Then we go here. Yeah, right then. So first things first, we need to go north. Oh no, down that is. No, actually we don't. We use this route. Use the room at the end of this here tunnel. And then we figure out where to go next. That I do not suppose leads anywhere. Yeah, so we take this here route and we go there, right. I remember this module. It's the same module from the... which quest was it? The Sisandas. Of course I can't change transportation center. I hit the wrong key there. Enemies nearby. Oh hi there, Daedroth. Time for you to die, son. It was funny though, it's still pretty funny to me how the Lich just came onto me with all those attacks out of nowhere and then died to his own spell because it got reflected back. Now I'll try exploring the rest of this dungeon, but if that does not work then... okay, let's go ahead and use like this here slot. I do not think there's like... I do not see any buttons that I could use to essentially... sorry, not that. Paralysis... I'm looking for a potion of levitation, to be honest. Short of that, I'll just use a potion of slow falling. I'll check this area out and... if it is not worth it, then I'll just go ahead and... try reporting the quest back to... well, essentially... the owner of the quest. It's just a zombie, there's nothing there. Oh no, I'm now... stuck on top of the zombie. Cool. Is there anything here? No, just a bit with a zombie. I wonder why this thing was here anyway. Ooh, a potion of reaction, which I cannot carry. Sad. But yeah, there was nothing here. Quite disappointing. I was expecting there to be more on this side. So I guess the only course of action left for me at this point is just... try reporting this quest back, because I cannot see what else I can do here. Pretty sure there are some areas left to explore, but I think that was the glitch that I was looking for. Not the glitch, like the Lich that I was looking for. So we might as well try reporting this quest back and seeing how that works out for us. We take this route and... right, so for now we go straight. I'll just make a save here. And where to now? We keep going straight, right? Oh wait, this section we have not explored yet. Right. Let's go and explore that. Could be that a Lich is hiding somewhere here. Oh fuck you. I mean, that Lich gave no dialogue, he just died. And while that seems a little sad, to be honest, oh yeah, this is not a platform, this is just a corner tile. It could totally be that that was the lich that we were looking for. I'll just explore this side as well, and then I'll try going elsewhere. Like, try going the other way, seeing if there's a lich there. Maybe the lich is here? No, it's just an empty chamber, nothing here. Not what we're looking for right here. Like, some of these quests in Daggerfall can be insane. Like, insanely difficult. Might as well check this side out. See all that it has to offer. See it in all its vain glory. I was expecting the fighter's quest to be shorter, like they usually are, but I guess you don't always get what you ask for, like get what you want. This is the first time I've seen these four pillars inside of this module here, but I suppose that's because there's like a coffin over there. I really think that that lich was the one that we were supposed to kill, because it was in a place with, what do you call it? Where were we supposed to go again? Where did it come from? Did we come from here? Yes, we did, right. Yeah, so we keep heading this way, east. Yeah, because that secret door is essentially a quest spawn spot, so that area is pretty much where quests will sometimes spawn for you. I do hope that I'm headed in the right way. Yes, I am. Well then. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna save in the emergency slot right here. Not because I'm about to jump off, but because I don't want to travel all the way back from the mouth of the dungeon just to, you know, resume this quest if I have to. I'll just transfer some of them. Actually, it does not matter, you know what? It does not matter, no. Vibrates underfoot. Ground vibrates underfoot. Wayrest. Yeah, let's travel to Wayrest. I've literally got 12,000 gold pieces on me. Well, a little short of that. Let me get on a horse and... Right. Let's hunt out the fighter scope, let's see what they have to say. Whether I have completed the quest or not, because I found the lich. It does not mean that was the lich that we were meant to destroy, even though it was in an area with, you know, a quest object, where a quest objective typically spawns. Let's see, have we finished the quest then? Oh yeah, we have. That was the Lich that we had to kill. I just didn't get the notification. I didn't get the memo that I had completed the quest. God damn it. I didn't expect to see you again, Grimfangs. No fooling. Akatosh must be looking out after you. Here's your 588 gold. Enjoy it. It's funny he says that Akatosh must be looking out after me. Because I am using Auri-el's shield. Auri-el is the elvish name, the ultimate name for Akatosh, the dragon god of time. Auri being his name and El being the respectful honorific that they add at the end of honorific suffix that they add at the end of names, the names of people that they revere. So Akatosh is Auri-el, and I'm practically using his shield, or a shield endowed with his powers. The same shield which essentially reflected whatever magic the Lich used on me back onto the Lich, because of which he died. So yeah, I mean, Akatosh is literally looking out for me at this point in time. Now I wonder if I have enough. Of course I can't. Yeah, maybe now I can. Yeah, thank you. Well, that was a hectic quest, but you know what, let's get another quest from this guy. I'm Edvor Hoothfing, I have a relatively menial job. Sure. I mean, after the grind that we just went through, might as well have a change of pace. Gondinax Shield. Now, where's Gondinax Shield? I do believe I knew where it was. I think it was somewhere in the... Over in this corner. Yeah, right here. Right next to Order of the Hour. So, yeah. Come on, let's go then. Now, typically I would be trying to increase my hand-to-hand in these quests, but I do need to improve my long blade, so I'm gonna go ahead and do exactly that. Improve my long blade instead of my hand-to-hand. Tell by this logo as well. That's an armorer's logo. Actually, let me go ahead and pull out my wagon. I think I had like a steel, yeah, like an iron katana. Let me use that instead, because it'll take more hits to essentially do away with these rats. Or bats, or whatever they are. And that in turn gives me... more experience towards leveling up my... skills. I heard one. I can't see it, but I heard one. It's a rat. See, typically it would be a one-hit kill if it was like the Daedric sword, it would be a one-hit kill, but I do not want it to be a one-hit kill, so... Actually, you know what, while we're at it, might as well sell it to you. Excuse me, let us sell this to you. Anything else that I have? Ah, yes, the Elven Greaves. Yeah, let's sell them to you. 62, 66, I'm probably gonna be offered half that. Less than half, apparently. Okay, I'll take it. Wayrest has a lack of proper shops. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I like the chandeliers hanging from the top. I like the feel of the shop, to be honest. It has got a very rustic feel to it. Enemies nearby. Enemies nearby. Essentially, that is the way to farm these quests. You just walk around until the game says that there are enemies nearby, and then you try and swat those enemies out. Ah, there you are. One more of you. So sometimes it takes them like 2 hits to go down. So if I can loiter for like 3 hours in a row, that means that my quest has been completed. But something I should probably do is remove this thing. Like, remove these things. No. yeah, that's pretty sad. No, that's not what I want to do. Cloth amulet. I do hope that these are in my... No, of course they're not. For some reason, I removed them into my pack and for whatever reason. Charisma. Open tunic of paralysis. I mean, I'd be stunned if I saw a woman in that tunic as well. Just saying. Yeah, let's equip this. Better sales prices. Don't exactly need the personality to going up against bats. I have finished loitering. So let me just loiter for like 2 more hours, as you see. If that is the case. Cool. What time is it right now? I hope that the fighter skill is still open. But typically, if it was Daggerfall, I would not want to be out on the streets right now. Thankfully, this is not Daggerfall. This is Wayrest, so I'm safe out here on the streets. I just hope I can go in and turn in the quest before it's too late. I sort of should not have rested for so long there. Sort of did like a mistake there, made a mistake there. If I'm not letting the fighter skilled anymore, then that's this is gonna be failed quest and I'm gonna have to start all over again. Since you only get like a day to finish this. That is Knight's Guild. This here would be the Fighter's Guild. Sorry, the Knightly Order. Knights of the Rose. This here would be the Fighter's Guild. Ah, thank God it's still open. Let us then talk to you. Killing bats of enchant ones doesn't take much skill, eh? But it does pay the same. Congratulations, Grimfangs. Because of your outstanding weaponry prowess, we have promoted you to the rank of Warder in the guild. Among other benefits, this increase means cheaper weapon repair and more profitable work assignments. Thank you very much. So, with that being done, how about we go out and just rest at a tavern or something? So, where is this? Where's the Queen's Hedgehog? To the southeast? Let's go. Let's go to the Queen's Hedgehog. I don't even know why I'm earning money these days, since everything is literally free from me. Stay... Food isn't free. Food isn't free. Weapons aren't free. Weapon repairs aren't free. But, yeah, I mean, it's like, stay... is free for me. And... literally, travel is free. So I don't really know why I'm even getting all this money, to be honest. But, since we are getting money, what's the time right now? Yeah, might as well rest for 12 hours. For 12 hours, come on. We'll wake up in the morning. It's a well-deserved rest. We had been scouring through a dungeon for a lich. And yeah, that was it for today. That's it for today. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we come back the next time, we will be covering a mainline quest, and I think it's about time we go ahead and give Majora her freedom back. So, until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.